Hai, selamat kembali ke channel saya. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys the makeups that I brought with me to Japan for my internship. But as expected, I didn't get to wear a lot of makeup because I spend most of my time in the lab and it's an internship, so ain't nobody got time for makeup at all. Even masa weekend jalan-jalan pun saya malas mau pakai makeup sebabnya saya lagi rela gunakan masa yang ada untuk tidur daripada pakai makeup. But still, saya bawa juga makeup ni untuk kepuasan diri sendiri, untuk sedapkan hati because it's just my habit to bring makeup wherever I go. So basically, that's my justification for bringing makeup with me even though I didn't use it at all. Please forgive me for the messy background. Bilik saya memang bersepa, saya malas mau kasih bersih. I'm just that lazy and I'm filming in front of this big window because good lighting. Okay, I look flawless walaupun sebenarnya tidak flawless. Saya akan tunjuk satu-satu barang yang ada di dalam ni. Mungkin ada orang yang berminat untuk tengok video macam ni, mungkin tidak. We're going to Daiso in a minute. I mean, we're going to Aeon. Di Aeon tu ada Daiso and I'm going to pick up a few of their cosmetics products from Daiso so that I can make a full face of Daiso makeup. So I hope you guys will enjoy this short video. Please leave a comment down below whether you are enjoying my Japan videos or not. If yes, I will upload more including the vlogs. Saya ada jalan-jalan masa weekend. Before I start, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and also jangan lupa untuk follow Instagram saya. I will link everything down below. And without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Saya letak semua makeup dalam travel makeup bag macam ni. I bought this from Kaison a few months ago. Harga dalam belas-belas ringgit sahaja. And size dia ni ngam-ngam, just nice. Tidak terlalu kecil sampaikan tidak muat barang. Tapi tidak terlalu besar sampaikan memakan banyak sangat stres dalam bag. And inside, it is full with makeups yang seperti saya cakap tadi, saya tidak sempat. Saya tidak sempat pakai langsung. Like, look at this. Full weight makeup. Saya bawa travel size makeup brushes daripada Miss Gorgeous. This one was sent to me in a PR kit. And this shop is from Shopee. Diorang suruh saya review produk ni. Dan saya sudah cuba. Saya sudah buat video cumanya belum edit. And I really like the quality of the brushes. Semuanya lembut-lembut. Tidak menyakitkan kulit. Tidak gatal ataupun pedih. Dan size dia pun pendek. Dia tidak panjang macam berus biasa. So, dia boleh muat dalam makeup bag saya dengan perfect. Actually, dia datang dalam pouch dia sendiri and saya keluarkan brush ni dari pouch sebab saya pakai pouch tu untuk simpan barang lain. But these are all multi-purpose. Yang ni boleh guna untuk contour, untuk blusher pun boleh. Bersin tapi tidak sampai. Bergantung kepada kreativiti masing-masing. Makeup brush ni saya akan letakkan link di bawah. You guys can go check it out if you are interested to own a travel friendly makeup brush set. Sebabnya semua lengkap. Ada foundation brush, ada eyeshadow brush. And you can also use this to apply concealer ataupun letak eyeshadow. So, dia ada banyak-banyak fungsi untuk satu berus. Saya bawa eyebrow brush ni daripada Ten Atira. This is my favorite eyebrow brush at the moment. Yang sebelah ni kita boleh guna untuk eyeliner ataupun untuk brow pomade. Yang lagi sebelah ni dia more to flat shader brush tapi saya suka pakai untuk bersihkan kening. I will leave a link to Ten Atira's makeup brushes. Saya percaya dia ada jual berus secara individu. Of course, travel size makeup remover and this is my favorite from Biore. Saya sudah bertahun-tahun pakai brand Biore ni sebagai makeup remover saya and I don't think I will change anytime soon because they are just so good. They function well and they didn't irritate my skin, so I highly recommend you guys to try this. Tidak kisahlah yang warna biru ataupun yang warna pink, rasanya dua-dua sama sahaja. Bagi saya tiada perbezaan sangat pun. Saya bawa kapas untuk double cleansing. Lepas saya pakai makeup remover yang macam ni, saya usually akan buka lagi sekali makeup dengan Biore cleansing water. As I told you guys, I really love Biore. I've been using it for years. So saya akan pakai kapas ni untuk double cleansing. Ada bawa a few foundation product, tudung terburuk. Please ignore my messy tudung, okay? Anyway, foundation yang saya bawa, satu daripada Muka & Co. Tint Glow Serum. This one is in shade Blush Glow, I think. I actually have never used this. Kononnya saya mau bawa pergi sini dan review. Tapi tiada masa untuk review. I am so sorry. Maybe I will try this like after my interview or during my interview tomorrow. Like, Yeah, I have internship interview, so I think I need to look a little bit more presentable. So I might use that as my foundation, this one. Ini botol kaca, okay. And I want to thank Muka and Glow for sending me this in their PR kit. They also sent me their newly launched Velvet Tint. There are 3 different shades and I brought it all together with me because I like the texture. It's not too matte, but it's not too glossy. It gives just the right moisture to my lips and it didn't emphasize any of the dryness on the lips and it didn't like sink into the fine line of my lips. Also, I love the color scheme, especially Sassy Brown and also this Burgundy, I think. And warna dia memang warna burgundy. I'm not a big fan of this peach maker because it looks a little bit clownish on my skin. However, I have seen a lot of people rocking this color and they look really really beautiful. It's just that I prefer these 2 color more, which is Sassy Brown and also Burgundy. I will show you guys the swatches later on, like maybe I will do a separate review for Muka & Co products, so stay tuned for that, okay? Dah pula, oh okay, rupanya saya ada bawa powder foundation, this one from Maybelline. I have reviewed this product before and I will also link it down below if you are interested to see my review or like to watch my review. And for compact powder, I bring the Egg Lips Blur Pack Powder. Saya ingat dulu Pony Makeup sangat-sangat suka produk ni. Dia selalu pakai dalam video dia. And that's why I decided to purchase this. Sebab dia punya blurring effect tu, fuh, memang padu. Dia memang menghaluskan kulit muka bagi nampak flawless macam Photoshop. Tapi sebenarnya it's just the powder. And Egg Lips boleh dibeli di Watson. So kalau berminat bolehlah check it out. Highlighter, saya bawa Maybelline Master Chrome Metallic Highlight. Yang ni shade 50, Molten Rose. And ini Alia bagi. And I'm thankful for her because I really 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 love this. Sangat 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 pigmented dan cantik di kulit. Dia nampak agak gelap untuk kulit saya. Tapi surprisingly, bila letak padan je, dia tidak terlalu gelap tapi tidak juga terlalu cerah. And just look at that beauty, okay? Sangat 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 blinding. If you are looking for a drugstore highlighter yang betul-betul cantik dan berkualiti tinggi, tolong cuba Maybelline Master Chrome. Seterusnya untuk blusher dan juga bronzer, saya bawa Palladium Matte Blush and Catrice Sun Glow Matte Bronzing Powder. These 2 are my favorite products from the drugstore also because this one, it's highly pigmented but not too pigmented yang sampaikan macam badut kalau kita pakai. And warna dia pun sesuai untuk Asian skin tone, at least in my opinion. Warna dia agak warm, panas-panas sikit, tidak terlalu pucat. And it looks like that. Rupanya tersalah swatch. Saya swatch pakai jari ni tapi actually jari ni yang ada produk. Let me show you. See? So 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 pretty. And I like this kind of blush color because I feel like it complements my skin tone better. Saya bawa O2O Silky Fiber Mascara. If I'm not mistaken, this is one of the new releases. I have also reviewed this in my latest video, so I will link the video down below for you guys to watch the application, the demo, and also my review. And for eyebrow, I bring the Fog Allure Artist Super Fine Brow Eye Pencil. Yang ni dia punya pencil sangat 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 kurus, super super precise. It's not too hard but it's not too waxy or slippery on my eyebrow hair. I just got back from Aeon. Tadi tidak sempat habiskan video, so saya stop sekejap and saya sambung balik sekarang lepas sampai bilik. There are only a few things to be shown left. Ada sikit je lagi dalam ni. Yang saya bawa ialah Maybelline Master Prime Anti Redness Primer. Saya suka yang ni sebabnya dia rasa ringan di kulit. Dia bukannya silicone primer, dia more to like lotiony type of primer. Looks like this. It's actually quite watery, so I like the texture a lot. And it feels lightweight on the skin. Dia tidak rasa greasy, dia tidak rasa macam pelik-pelik di kulit. And it also give like a smoothing effect on the skin. Maybe kamu tidak boleh nampak sekarang sebab lighting saya tidak berapa on point. Sekarang sudah malam, okay? Walaupun baru jam 5:14 petang, but it's already night time here in Japan. Let me show you guys the current weather right now. Yeah. See? Malam. It's night time already. Tada! Gelap. Very, very dark. So yeah, di Japan masa winter dia punya malam cepat datang. I also bring an under eye primer from Catrice. I have reviewed this product too and I will link it the video down below. Walaupun sebenarnya dia tiadalah efek yang signifikan bila pakai di bawah mata. You can literally see the result in my review video that it has a not that many difference with or without this primer. Tapi saya bawa juga untuk sedapkan hati. Okay, like, I'm so weird like that. Lepas itu, concealer pula, saya bawa dua jenis. Satu corrector, satu lagi concealer biasa lah. And this one is Innisfree Color Correcting, Smart Drawing Color Correcting in the color peach. I love, 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 love this. Sebab texture dia ringan dan dia tidak rasa berat bawah mata. And it neutralize my dark circle perfectly. And also untuk concealer, saya memang berniat untuk bawa concealer yang tidak full coverage, yang rasa ringan, yang tidak rasa over. These two are my favorite products too. I have been using this for a very, very long time. And matte liquid lipstick juga, just in case saya mau pakai matte lipstick. This is from Beat Beauty and I believe these are new from them. Ni saya ada buat video di IG, saya swatch di bibir. Packaging diorang yang kotak memang sangat-sangat comel, macam mau simpan di vanity table, tidak mau buang. And the liquid lipstick comes in 3 travel friendly size like this. Warna dia semua sesuai untuk daily makeup. So sebab tu juga saya bawa diorang, sebabnya dia tidak terlalu garang tapi tidak terlalu pucat. And I like the texture, it's watery but it's also pigmented. Cuma ada satu warna yang agak patchy, saya tidak ingat yang mana satu. And it feels really really light on the lips. It doesn't feel like thick liquid lipstick, no. Dia rasa macam apply air di bibir. And bau dia macam bau coklat. No, not coklat, like cookie. Oh, saya ada bawa cream concealer juga. Yang ni khas untuk bersihkan kening. This is in shade 01 Fair. Walaupun dia shade yang paling terang. Cerah. Tapi dia tidaklah secerah yang disangka. Dia still gelap. And dia macam, this is more like a medium. Lepas tu shade yang medium, more like a dark. You know what I mean? Like, dia tidak secerah yang kita selalu nampak di kedai. Ada bawa, of course, eyelash curler and also eyeliner pun daripada O2O. Yang ni diorang hantar dalam PR, saya ada review juga dalam video O2O baru-baru ni. And I said in the video I like this a lot, so that's why I bring this to travel with me. Look at the pigmentation, it's really 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 opaque and it dries down to a matte finish. So sebab tu saya bawa walaupun tidak pakai. Then ada Etude House Dr. Mascara Fixer. Yang ni dia macam mascara base. Dia akan lentikkan bulu, bukan berlentikkan. Kalau kita lentikkan bulu mata, lepas tu kita apply yang ni, nanti curl tu dia tidak akan jatuh langsung. Dia macam base untuk mascara lah. Cuma kita tidak jatuh langsung and dia akan like tambahkan lagi volume kepada bulu mata. So that's why I like this. Brow gel daripada Colourpop. This is just like a normal brow gel. I really 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 enjoy using this sebabnya dia tidak membuatkan bulu kening saya keras, tapi dia still setkan bulu kening supaya dia tidak bergerak di sana sini. So yeah, basically it's just like a normal eyebrow gel, looks like this. Beauty sponge ni dapat dari Miss Gorgeous and saya sudah buat video juga, saya demokan macam mana saya guna sponge ni. Surprisingly, I like this kind of sponge sebabnya satu, dia lembut. Bila dia basah, dia akan mengembang dua kali besar daripada size normal dan disebabkan size bukan bentuk dia yang bersegi ni, so senang untuk saya back bawah mata. Lepas tu surface yang besar ni saya guna untuk blend foundation, and then surface yang agak kecil macam yang pointy ni saya guna untuk blend di corner mata macam ni. So it's actually a really good shape to blend your foundation and also your concealer as well as baking your under eyes. And last but not least, saya bawa a mini, bukanlah mini, dia macam eyelash curler tapi lagi kecil dari yang normal. Saya beli ni khas untuk curlkan bulu mata yang di corner sebabnya bulu mata, bukan, bentuk mata saya ni downward, dia menurun ke bawah. So, a normal eyelash curler won't be able to reach the end of my eyes. And selalunya bulu mata tu akan macam tu. And I don't like that. What I will do is that I will take this small one and I will curl specifically at the end right here. So, rata lah curl tu kan. Semua rata, tereng tertinggal. So, basically that's all of the makeup that I brought with me even though I didn't use most of them. But seeing them gives joy to me and I always feel happy whenever I see my makeup. I don't know why. So thank you so much for watching and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!